Bonjour à tous. Hello everybody. Welcome to my channel. I'm glad that you are here. Do you know that Vienna has a great coffeehouse culture, so that UNESCO put the Vienna cafe culture on the intangible cultural heritage list for Austria? But what does actually define the Viennese coffeehouse culture? I learned that the truly defining element of the Viennese coffeehouse culture is the absence of any kind of pressure either to order more or to move on. I would have spent hours reading a book at these nice Viennese cafes. But I planned a packed schedule every day, so I was not able to spend time at a cafe as much as I'd have liked to. Still, we stayed at least an hour at each cafe we visited. Even though Vienna's coffeehouses share a common culture, each tends to have its own unique flavor. And I would like to introduce 5 extraordinary Viennese cafes to you. Are you ready to see 5 great coffeehouses in Vienna? Let's go! Allons-y! Café Gloriette must probably be the most imperial coffeehouses in Vienna, or in Austria. The café is inside of the Gloriette in the Schönbrunn Palace Garden. The Gloriette stands on higher ground in Schönbrunn Palace Park and is a great lookout point for the garden of the palace. The building was built in 1775 as the last building constructed in the garden. Empress Maria Theresa decided the Gloriette should be designed to glorify Habsburg power, and it certainly shows off the glory of the Habsburg period. It was used as a dining hall and festival hall, as well as a breakfast room for Emperor Franz Joseph I. The dining hall was used until the end of the monarchy. Today it houses Café Gloriette. It's mid-morning, so all the bar tables by the windows are taken. It's fine with me, since I can see the palace and the garden when I go out. I appreciate the imperial ambience and interior from our table. There is a nice selection of cakes. We order our coffees and a slice of Apfelstrudel. For coffee, we order a browner and a Maria Theresa coffee, which is double espresso with orange liqueur and whipped cream. You definitely taste the liqueur in this coffee. Coffee smells wonderful and apple strudel is delicious. Their taste is enhanced by the ambience. How can they not, right? It is a beautiful winter morning at Schönbrunn Palace. We stroll around before entering the palace to see the imperial grandeur of the famous palace. Café Frauenhuber is a traditional coffeehouse in Himmelfortgasse 6 in Vienna's 1st District, inner city. It is one of the oldest coffeehouses in the city, and is considered the oldest continuously operating Viennese coffeehouse. Maria Theresa's personal chef and court entertainer Ignaz Jan founded a noble restaurant at the end of the 18th century. Concerts were also held in this restaurant, including performances by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart and Ludwig van Beethoven in person. The café restaurant moved to the current location in 1824 by a different owner. And the coffee house has been run under the name Café Frauenhuber since 1891. The coffee house was renovated in 2000, but it certainly maintains the charm of the old glorious days of the 19th century. We've heard that Frauenhuber's Sauertorte is one of the best Sauertorte in Vienna, so we must order it and check it out. When you order coffee in Vienna, they always bring you a glass of water and a face-down spoon on a small tray. The glass of water served with coffee meant to cleanse the palate. The face-down coffee spoon on top of the glass is a sign that the glass has been freshly filled up, and it is said to be a remnant of the Habsburg etiquette. Sauertorte is good, but I cannot say it is outstanding. Café Landtmann is a traditional Viennese coffee house opened on October 1, 1873. In 1929, the coffee house was expanded and completely renovated by a famous architect under the new ownership. It was during this renovation that Café Landtmann received its extravagant and lavish interior decorations, which are still preserved to this day. The interior of Café Landtmann is elegant and graceful. The only problem is that waiting is quite long and it's busy at any time of the day. I could enjoy the interior and ambience of this coffee house all day. As Landtmann has an in-house patisserie, they offer a great variety of cakes. We have a hard time choosing only two. Once your order is served, they leave you in peace, which is great. A Landtmann's Autorte, it is a scrumptious cake. You wouldn't believe how rich and moist it is. Moist chocolate sponge is divided and sandwiched by a tang of apricot jam. And the entire cake is covered in a buttery dark chocolate ganache. When you go to Café Landtmann, you must try their Zautorte. It's so good. I'm just too impressed by Landtmann's Zautorte. Their Maroni Blutte is very good too. Maroni Blutte can be translated as chestnut blossom. It is made of chocolate-covered waffle cup, preserved sour cherries, chestnut mousse, and chestnut puree. It's creamy, buttery, and soft all at the same time. Café Central is a traditional Viennese café that occupies the ground floor of the former bank and stock market building, today called the Palais Ferstal. The café was opened in 1876. The café closed at the end of World War II. In 1975, the Palais Ferstal was renovated and Café Central was newly opened, although in a different part of the building. In 1986, it was fully renovated once again. There is a reason why Café Central is so popular with the tourists. Entering the café, we are more than impressed by its majestic columned room. Its vaulted palatial interior is truly stunning. Yes, I think the vaulted high ceiling plays a big part in the grand character of the place. All its displayed cakes look too pretty to eat, nonetheless delicious. Café Central also has an in-house patisserie to create these cakes. It is a huge place, but it's already packed at 8:30 in the morning. There are a few teams ahead of us in the queue, but we don't wait more than 5 minutes. Café Central offers breakfast, lunch, and dinner on top of beverages and cakes. When you choose a cake, it is easier to go to the cake display where you can see a few dozen cake options. Each cake is numbered, so you can just give the number assigned to the cake you want to order to the server. We order breakfast and a Café Central Schnitte, a custard vanilla cream cake. It's in your mouth and breakfast is well presented. Service is good, but everything is kind of dwarfed by the grandeur of the setting itself. Be noted that it is extremely touristic. Nonetheless, it's worth a visit. Just like Landtmann, the line is long unless you go there early in the morning, which means before 9 a.m. Okay, I get it. I figure that you are wondering what this is. Yes, this is my cafe in the Hauptbahnhof, central train station of Vienna. My cafe is very different in Vienna. It's an exquisite my cafe. My cafe in Vienna encompasses a Viennese coffee house where a variety of coffees are offered along with quite an assortment of cakes. Well, the difference is that you gotta serve yourself at my cafe. Otherwise, it smells like a coffee house with aromatic coffee and quite decent cakes. Here, you can be as productive or idle as you like. And cost-wise, you can enjoy coffee and cake at a fraction of the price you'd spend at a traditional Viennese coffee house. For today, that's all from me. There are many more beautiful and famous coffee houses in Vienna. I hope to introduce more next time. If you have enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. I really appreciate it. Please subscribe if you want to see more of my weekly videos. I hope to see you again next week. Thanks for watching.